Hey, this is Travis the Tau Templar. This is an introduction to how the Bittensor network works at a high level. Bitcoin rewards the miner that solves the next block's hash. This is often critiqued as useless work. Wouldn't it be cool if Bitcoin's miners could be doing something more valuable? Bittensor's structure rewards miners that produce valuable work by using the same limited supply emission schedule as Bitcoin. You can think of Bittensor as a network of decentralized businesses. We call these businesses subnets. Each subnet produces a different product and has three types of workers. Miners are like the employees, they do the work. Validators are like the managers, they check the work. Subnet owners are like the CEOs, they control the work. Validators rank order miners based on the quality of their work. Miners submit their work to validators and are paid in a cryptocurrency called Tau based on their rank. Let's look at how this plays out with some real-world examples. In the storage subnet, miners are given the work of storing data. Validators give miners files to store and then check that the data has been stored correctly. When a validator confirms that a miner is great at consistently storing data, they'll give that miner a higher rank. When a validator finds that a miner has lost data, that validator will lower the miner's rank. Therefore, the best miners at providing storage will receive the most rewards, and the subnet will rely on them more. What about bandwidth, cheaters, amount of storage? The subnet owner invested a lot of money to own a subnet and control its work. Subnet owners are paid based on the success of their subnet, so owners want the highest quality of work. When needed, subnet owners will change the way validators rank order their miners to address the concerns like bandwidth, cheaters, amount of storage, etc. Let's look at a different subnet. In the trading signal subnet, miners are given the work of telling validators their trades in real time. Specifically, miners tell validators about their live trading positions. Then later, when a miner's trade is completed, validators check to see how well the miner did. When a validator finds that a miner was profitable, the validator will increase that miner's rank. When a validator finds that a miner has lost money, the validator will lower that miner's rank. Therefore, the best miners at trading will get the most rewards, and the subnet will rely on them more. The subnet owner's goal is to have trading signals from miners that are low risk and profitable so that traders will want to purchase the live trading signals. Therefore, the subnet owner needs to balance profitability with risk. So the subnet owner has validators rank miners based not only on profitability, but also on the risk. The lower, the better. In these two subnets, the types of work performed by miners, validators, and subnet owners are very different, but the structure of every subnet is the same. Miners do the work, validators check it, and subnet owners control the work. Most subnets have an AI focus. They are doing AI inference, parallelized training, AI image generation, sound, video, scraping, etc. New subnets are being added almost daily. The types of subnets that are possible are limitless. In addition to checking the work, validators can sell access to subnet products to customers outside of the network. The only way to access the commodities produced by miners in the network is through a validator. The only way to become a validator is to have a lot of Tau. Therefore, Tau is tied to the value of the commodities produced in Bittensor. Bittensor is highly competitive. Miners within a subnet compete against other miners to increase their rank within the subnet, which increases their Tau rewards. Validators compete to provide subnet access to customers outside the network. Subnet owners compete within the Bittensor market against other subnet owners to get more Tau rewards for their subnet. The last participants in Bittensor are stakers. Stakers are like the shareholders. They invest and judge the value of the work. Staking is similar to holding shares. By staking, stakers vote for the subnets they feel are most valuable. The subnets with more tau staked to them end up with more tau rewards to distribute to their miners, validators, and subnet owners. Each participant is paid for their work.
Recall that miners are paid for doing the work, validators are paid for checking the work, subnet owners are paid for controlling the work, and stakers are like the shareholders. They are paid in staking rewards for judging the value of the work.
Bittensor is a permissionless, decentralized economy with decentralized digital businesses and shareholders.